Hey, welcome to Grafana for Beginners. I'm Lisa Jung, and I'm a developer advocate at Grafana. In the previous episode, we talked about how to set up and run the self-managed editions of Grafana. Today, we'll go over how to create a Grafana Cloud account. Grafana is available as software as a service. If you'd rather focus on observing your system and not worry about installing, maintaining, and scaling Grafana on top of that, Grafana Cloud would be the way to go. There's no credit card required to get started. You get a free trial to the Pro tier for 14 days. After that, you'll still have access to the free open source Grafana functionality on Grafana Cloud. Everything we'll cover in the series can be accomplished with a free tier, and it should give you plenty of resources to explore what Grafana can do. So let's create a Grafana Cloud account. When you go to this link, it'll take you to the Grafana Cloud homepage. The same link is also included in the description. When you click on the Create the Account button, it'll prompt you to choose your sign-in method. You could either choose a single sign-in option so you don't have to remember any credentials, or you can sign up using your email and password. If you decide to sign up with your email, you have to verify your email address as a last step. You should get an activation code in your inbox, so all you have to do is to enter the code here in the box shown, and the site will take care of the rest. Next, you'll decide a unique name, the URL, for your Grafana instance. You can go directly to your Grafana environment by pasting the URL into your browser. Then you could choose a region closest to you, then click on the Finish Setup button. Now you'll be taken to the resource page that helps you to get started with Grafana. That's literally all you need to do to create a Grafana Cloud account. Next step is to connect the data sources to Grafana so you could start visualizing our data. Now, there are countless data sources that you could connect to Grafana. This series will mainly focus on Loki, Mimir, and Tempo. Throughout the series, we'll connect these data sources to Grafana to visualize logs, metrics, and traces. Now, if you want to access more episodes of Grafana for Beginners series, go to the Grafana community webpage. This is where all the community resources are shared. You can access the series by clicking on the Grafana for Beginners card. I also want to introduce you to the dashboard card. This page contains resources regarding how to use dashboards to visualize your data. When you scroll down on the page, it allows you to search for dashboards that the Grafana community has created. You can filter by category, panel, data source, collector types, and gain inspiration from how the community members with various technologies and data sources are using Grafana to visualize their data. You can also upload and share your dashboards with the community as well. All right, that's a wrap. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.